Today I want to talk about the best months of the year to invest your money. Hey everyone, welcome back to Drawbridge Finance. My name is Levi Woods and this is an opinion channel about money. The other day I was watching an interview with billionaire investor Ken Fisher, and he was talking about the time of year that where the stock market performs the best. Going into 2018, he believes, as I do, that we're going to have a very bullish year again. So we're expecting to see somewhere between like a 15 and 25% return on the major American indexes. But he said something that really grabbed me. He talked about the first 4 months of the year and the last 4 months of the year being the years where we see the most growth. Those middle 4 months are kind of static. Now, of course, I always like to analyze information like this myself. So I decided to look at three different ETFs. The DIA for the Dow Jones Industrial Average, the SPY for the S&P 500, and the QQQ for the NASDAQ. If I look at the historical prices of these three ETFs over the last 25 years, I might be able to see some sort of correlation, and I'll be able to see if there's months that consistently return either less or greater returns. Seems pretty simple. Let's build a spreadsheet. I've pulled historical data from specific dates and times. So I've taken the first day of each month, the closing value of this particular ETF, from January 1st, 1998, February 1st, 1998, and I've mapped out from inception, January 1st, when this ETF started in 1998, down to January 1st of 2018. Then what I've done is I've calculated out the simple annual return. I just did a video the other day on the SPY and the QQQ, and you guys should check that out to see how much these can return over time. So we're just gonna breeze through it in this one. The simple annualized return is shown per year. The return price from 2010 is calculated off the price January 1st, 2010 to the price January 1st, 2011, giving us the simple moving average of 17.95%. But this information isn't very visual. What I want is a color-coded chart like I like to build. So let's take a look. What this data is it calculates the price difference between January 1st of 1998 to February 1st of 1998, giving us the percentage return for that month. Now we can actually see some value. So I've highlighted in green some of the values that are in the high zone. So we can see in any given year, the worst month in 1998 was July, we saw the biggest downturn, and we saw the best months were January, August, September, and October. What we're looking for is all of this information over time. So let's look down at the bottom of the chart. Looking down at the row that says monthly average, it's pretty easy to see that January returned 0.49% on average. February, 1.7%. The biggest gains were in February, March, September, October, and November. We had either downturns or flat averages in the middle 5 months, April through August. I've also added another line which just gives me a number count of how many of the last 20 years, 13 years have been positive, 7 have been negative. 14 positive, 6 Februarys have been negative. Now that we've looked at this for the Dow Jones Industrial Average, let's look at it for the SPY. Same sort of setup. This ETF goes back a little bit further, going back to 1993. On the right, we can see the simple annual return for each year. So we can see our down years in 2000, and then our last big recession in 2008. Get down to this chart, and we can see our monthly averages. Very, very similar. February, March, then we've got some down months, April through August, and then we've got positive months, September, October. Again, looking down here, we've got this comparison. Of the 25 Januaries from 1993 to present, 15 of them have been positive and 10 have been negative return. We can see that the best months return-wise are March, April, and then September, October, November. Now I want to do this again for the NASDAQ. QQQ has only been around since March of 1999. Again, we can see these massive annual returns. Now this is not inclusive of the dividend. This would be an additional 2% dividend on top of these simple annual average of 11%. Of the last 18 Januaries, 9 positive, 9 negative. February, 12 positive, 6 negative. Again, we can see this correlation. The NASDAQ has had a bit better performance in June and July, but we can definitely see that February, March, and April, September, October, have had more positive months than the middle portion of the year. So I've created a little summary sheet. What this does is it shows you all three of the indexes combined. So we look at the DIA, the SPY, and the QQQ. Now these are all dividend paying ETFs, so you have to add that extra 2% dividend that each of these would receive. But the monthly average for all three of these combined in January, 0.24%, February, 1.35%, March, 1.96%. Looking at this chart, I can come to some pretty easy conclusions. The January is when I want to be buying. Again, I also want to be buying in August. If I buy at the end of the low cycle, then I am putting my money in at the time when it's most likely going to make money faster. This is also something we should consider because of tax season. We have the first 60 days of the year that we can contribute to our RRSPs. For TFSA accounts, we can deposit any time over the whole year. So if I get my money in January, my whole $5,500 in there, it has the entire year to grow, which means I will see better returns and compound more money over time. Hopefully this little bit of research was enlightening to you guys. It sure was for me. I can't wait to invest some more today. Remember, it really helps my channel if you leave a like or a comment below. Thanks so much, everybody. Let's get rich together.